In the last class, we have discussed about the northern plain. Today, we are discussing about the parts of northern plain. So, three parts of northern plain are Punjab plain, Ganga plain, and Brahmaputra plain. So, the Punjab plain lies in the western part of the plain. It has been formed by the Indus and its many tributaries. The larger part of this plain lies in Pakistan. The Indus and its tributaries are the Jhelum, the Ravi, the Satluj, the Bias and the Chenab, which has been originated in the Himalayas. The Punjab plain is also be dominated by Dobs. Dobs, it is nothing but two rivers, or you may say two waters. Ganga plain, it is the middle part of the plain. It exists from the Ganga river in Haryana and the Teesta river in West Bengal. So the states of Haryana, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, partly Jharkhand and West Bengal. The Brahmaputra plain, it is the eastern part of the plain. It exists from Assam to Bangladesh. See, the Punjab plain lies in the western part of the plain. Ganga plain, it lies in the middle part of the plain. Whereas the Brahmaputra plain, it is the eastern part of the plain. So today we are discussing about the regions of northern plain. So here four regions are there. Along its bed, the northern plain is divided into four regions according to the variation to relieve future are as follows. First region is Bhabar, second is Terai, third Bhangar and fourth one Khadar. First we will discuss about the Bhabar. After descending from the mountains, the river deposits pebbles in the narrow belt of about 8 to 16 kilometers in width length parallel to the slopes of the Shivaliks. It is known as Bhabar belt. All the rivers disappear from the Bhabar belt. Now Terai, south of Bhabar belt, the streams and rivers re-emerge and create a wet, swampy and marshy region known as Terai. Earlier, it is a thickly forested with a lot of wildlife, but now most of the forest having been cleared for agriculture purposes and settled migrants from Pakistan after independence. Some forest still remains here. Duwa National Park, it is located in this region. Now we will discuss about the Bhangar. The largest part of northern plain, consisting of older aluminium and known as Bhangar. It presents a terrace-like feature and contains calcareous deposit known as Kankas. Now Khadar, the lowest region is the floodplain known as Khadar. The soil here is renewed whenever there is flood. Almost every year, so this area is fertile and best for initiative and it is best for intensive agriculture. Now we'll discuss about the peninsular plateau. This is the tableland composed of all crystalline, igneous and metasporic rocks. Rocks, if we talk about the rocks, some are hard, some are soft and some are very hard. It was formed due to the breaking up and drifting of Gondwana land. Thus, it is a part of oldest landmass. The plateau has broad and shallow valleys and rounded hills. This plateau contains of two broader divisions. The two broader divisions are Central Highlands and Deccan Plateau. See the Central Highland. This is the another part lying in north of the Narmada River, which covers most of Malwa Plateau. The Vidyan Range is bounded by the Central Highland on the south and eroded up broken aravels of the northwest. Its further westernward extents gradually merged with the sandy and rocky deserts of Rajasthan. It slopes from southwest to the northeast, as indicated by the flow of Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Kin rivers. I am again repeating the river's name. See, it slopes from southwest to the northeast, as indicated by the flow of these rivers. The rivers are the Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Kin rivers. The central highlands are wider in the north, in the west, but narrower in the east. Its eastern edge consists of the areas known as Bundelkhand and Bengalkhand. The Chota Nagpur Plateau marks the further eastward extension drained by the Damodar rivers. In the next class, we will discuss about the Deccan Plateau, Western and Eastern Ghat, Deccan Trap, and the Indian Desert. Thank you.